A closer look now at the enforcement of safe distancing and the wearing of face masks here in Singapore. Environment and Water Resources Minister Masago Zulkifli says that people can do better when it comes to complying with mask-wearing rules. My colleague Ateli Edwards has been speaking to him on News 5.
For the last few days, we have been fining 200 people on a daily basis, except that this time, the people who violated safety distancing measures number about 150 or more, slightly more than that, and then the number who violated mask wearing is 50. Well, for mask wearing, I think it's a good start. The numbers are very manageable, 50, and looking around, photographs that enforcement officers have been sending me, I'm quite pleased. But I think, of course, we can do better.
Right. And Minister, we know that there are exceptions, like we heard earlier from the doctors, for example, someone is engaging in strenuous exercise, they don't need to wear the mask. But I'm wondering to what extent will the authorities go to find out whether or not someone is actually telling the truth?
Look, I think the most important thing to remember is to stay home. Stay home as much as possible so that we all protect ourselves and protect each other. Go out for the essentials like exercising. And if you know that you're going to find hard breathing while you are exercising hard, then don't put on the mask. But please, the moment you finish exercising, put it on. I don't think we will have a hard and fast rule looking at people running around whether they should or should not put a mask on. But clearly, when they are done, we will require them to do so.
Mm. Also, can you just share with us some examples of cases where rules were flouted but might not be so apparent? In other words, you know, some of the common misperceptions that maybe you'd like to highlight.
Well, the rule says that for those who are below 2 years old, you don't have to wear a mask. For those who are exercising strenuously, particularly running in the open, you don't have to put on a mask. Beyond that, clearly everyone should put it on. There will be exceptions, and if they are, for example, for special needs, and it's very difficult to do so, I think we can be understanding, certainly.
Mm. And also, I understand that we've got a few thousand of these officers, enforcement officers on the ground. What kind of changes must we see before you think there'll be a relaxation in terms of the enforcement operations?
Firstly, like I mentioned, if everybody stay home as much as possible, and if they even when they go out, space it out, I think we'll need less people on the ground. It's important for us to remind ourselves that the safe distancing measures are meant to protect ourselves and those around us. Remember, I like to remind everybody that the latest case that was highlighted about 2 days ago, a 70-year-old male who passed away, he caught this virus because he was in a big setting among his family members at a private dinner in Safra. And that the onset of that infection came about on the 5th of March, and he passed on the 14th of April. So it is in the interest of everybody to ensure that we keep this safety distancing strictly, so that we do not pass our virus that we may have to one another. And more importantly, when you're out there in public, put on your mask, because you do not know whether you have asymptomatic, you are asymptomatic and passing on this virus to others.